turns out that if you line up the 10 highest mountains in the UK, they aren't all that far apart. In fact, a lot of them are stacked up nearby each other. They're all in Scotland, and they've all got some pretty awesome skiing potential. To hike and to ski all 10 of them is a great goal for the ambitious backcountry skier or snowboarder. The Cairngorm 4000ers route can even link 5 of the top 10 together into one massive day out. And Ben Nevis, the UK's highest summit, also has 3 more of the top 10 peaks within viewing distance. So what if? What if you could hike and ski all 10 of them in one long weekend and be back in time for work on Monday morning? As well as the driving in between, it would be about 75 kilometres in the legs with 7,000 metres of ascent. It's a silly idea. But this was the idea of Blair Aitken and Gavin Carruthers, two teachers who also run British backcountry courses. These ski touring instructors have been skiing and guiding in the Scottish mountains so much that they might just have the experience and skill set to pull it off. And rather than just being a summit bagging mission, this was a skier's objective, with a goal to ski an interesting descent off each mountain. To match schedules, we had to choose the weekend months in advance. So would there be enough snow? Would we get a weather window? Is there even enough daylight? I had no idea. I had not even been skiing in Scotland before, but before I knew it, it was time to go and find out the answers to those questions. First up was Ben Lorge. This 10th highest peak is separate from the others and would therefore need to be ticked off on the Friday before lining up the remaining 9 peaks in 2 big days over the weekend. But being late April, the amount of snow on its northeast face was one of the biggest question marks of the weekend. But this is what we found. Ben Lorge in the bag, we drove to Fort William and hiked from the North Face car park to the beautiful CIC hut.
It's quite a long approach because just like in Ben Lorge, most of the snow lowdown has gone.
I'm not sure I took you the best way. It's not really an adventure until you've crossed the river.
We're going to meet up with some friends at the CIC hut.
We teamed up with Scottish ski touring expert Dave Anderson, local free skier Robert Kingsland, and ski and outdoor instructor Alex Watt. On Friday night, it felt like we were preparing for battle, hunkering down in the refuge with an aggressive wind howling outside. But it was here that we came across the legendary JimBob McCluskey, with his song about the flies that you sometimes see stuck in the skin track.
Little fly guy, what you doing in my way? I don't want to kill you, so I guess I better step another place and let you live your life. You might have a family, you might have a fly wife, little fly maggot babies back at home, but I ain't gonna pick up no bone with them, cause they never done nothing to me.
Early on Saturday morning, we scrambled the ledge route up Ben Nevis, making sure to tread carefully around any insects in our way. Plan A was to ski Tower Gully, but we had no time to wait for the sun to reach it, and it was still too icy for good skiing. The wind was strong, but the skies were clear. The scenery was stunning, and over in number 5 gully, the snow was softening.
Damn, it's dropping in.
After a steep and narrow morning on Nevis, we headed up the other side of the valley to Cairnmorgellig. Now, we won't talk about the hike, but it was worth it for the perfect spring snow we found on the other side.
Blair is going first, DMD line 1.
fourth Munro. First, we need to get to the col between Annachbeg and Annachmoor, and then we'll climb and ski our last two lines.
Despite the recent heatwave, which had dramatically stripped the mountain of snow, we still managed to find some fun skiing to make the long approaches worthwhile.
Day to the summit of Annachmoor, and from there we'll choose one of the descents into the back quarries.
One little problem with our route is that this loop wasn't really a loop. We've been going about 10 hours and we were still heading away from the car.
So we are 9 kilometres from our starting point. Not ideal.
But the sunset soothed sore feet as we walked to the valley floor, reflecting on a great day in the hills. 5 down and 5 to go. We drove 2 hours to Aviemore, clocked a couple of hours of sleep, and before we knew it, it was Sunday morning. On Sunday, we took on the Cairngorm 4000ers. I didn't know exactly what to expect, but Blair and Gavin were making me a little nervous.
This is the big day.
It's a longer day than yesterday.
And now we are going to do our 5 remaining Munros.
A few big ascents, starting with this one up towards Ruby, 800 metres to kick us off.
We had planned a 32 kilometre route with around 3,000 metres of ascent. It wouldn't have seemed right to complete the weekend in clear skies, and we were battling volatile winds and popping in and out of epic cloud formations all day. But this is what we were here for, wild scenery in the remote Scottish backcountry. Skiing isn't all about easy turns in perfect snow and friendly weather. It's about adventure. It's about accessing awesome places. But of course, the descent is still the main event.
Central Punches Gully!
We're now climbing up East Gully. First time on the crampons.
Next up, the Angel's Face was the prize objective of the weekend, a picturesque pyramid which sticks out over the Larrick Grue. But with a steep and exposed entrance, strong winds and whiteout cloud coming in and out, this epic line wasn't going to give itself up easily.
Blair, you have 1 meter of rope left.
Still bloody steep here. It steepens in the narrow, like quite a bit. I can't do it. Yeah, I gotta climb back up, Gav. Bloody hell, this is steep. 25 meter descent, side slipping, does that count?
It was a shame to skip this face, but the mountains told us to come back another day instead. We took the safer option down the southeast ridge, and before we knew it, we were on top of Cairntowl and ready to ski something a little bit more lighthearted. We skied the streamline back down to the Larrick Grue Valley and got back into that all too familiar uphill rhythm.
Oh, it's nice and warm, isn't it?
We are skinning up Ben McDooey, second highest mountain in Scotland, and the second last mountain of our trip.
By the time we reached the summit of Ben McDooey, the weather closed in on us. Navigating to Castlegate Gully took some concentration, but once we were in between its walls, we had enough visibility to ski it and make our way down to the beach at Lochan.
Yew!
One last slog up the waterfall path and we summited Cairngorm late on Sunday night.
So 2.5 days, 10 highest mountains in the UK, 9 descents completed, one final one to go, and we're going to go down the Coronation Wall and down through the cast. Nice easy one to finish because it is 10 o'clock at night.
By 4 a.m. we were back in Edinburgh. And of course, come 9 a.m. Monday morning, Blair and Gavin burst joyously into work, well rested and fully charged for the week ahead. And what did we learn? Well, this was another reminder that skiing is about much more than just sliding downhill. It's about the round trip, the scenery and the solitude, the characters and the comedy. Despite the challenges, we had a lot of fun. That's why hiking to earn your turns is so rewarding, and that's why Scotland is an excellent place to go skiing.